I think it was a pretty tough swim, at least on my side. I hit so many guys and I had a problem with the first buoy that, yeah, I don't know, I was hit by everyone, so I lost some positions, but the second lap I could go forward a bit, so I was sure I was in the first pack. And the bike, we tried the first two laps, a small group of 10, 11 guys, but they came fast from behind, and so we got caught, and from then on I knew it was gonna be a running race, so just try to stay comfortable in the pack and, you know, be aware of all the movements if someone tries to break away. But yeah, finally it was a big pack and everyone ready for running. Then the last lap was a bit of tension, you know, because everyone wants to be in the first positions for the transition. So it was a bit dangerous, the last corner. It's not like a tour, but this course, which is pretty technical and narrow, the last part for transition is narrow and with some corners. So obviously we're, I don't know, 60 guys, 55 guys in the bike, and everyone wants to be in the front. So you're touching the others, you are trying to find your place to go front, and it's a bit, it's like a jungle there. it's not funny at all, but luckily there was no crash, there was not any big problem. I could be in the top 10 maybe for the second transition. And then since you start running, I felt good, and it was gonna be a good day. Frodo was the fastest one in the second transition. I'm not really, really good in transitions. I always start a bit behind, but was in top 10, I think, and they were not far away. So I just ran a bit faster the first K, and I kind of easily catch them. So I said, okay, now stay here for a while, recover a bit, and then from the second, third lap start to go fast. But obviously, Frodeno was really tough. Until the last K, I couldn't do it. I tried hard in the third lap, and K7, K8, and finally in K9, I could drop it off, which was great to win here with such a big crowd and a really nice city, so I'm really glad. And I had to give everything to beat him.
Well, I always think it must have been interesting coming into this race, having been here in 2007. You were ranked number one in the world, and I remember speaking to you after the race, and it was tough to see you having got run down by Unger.
Yeah.
Do you come to this race thinking about that at all?
Yeah, obviously it's something that I remember. I was not really disappointed at that time. It was my first podium in the World Championship, so
yeah.
It was good anyway. But when you are so close to victory and finally, yeah, that day Danny was really, really fast in the final sprint. And when I was running, you know, next to Frodo the last lap, I said, oh, damn it, it can't be the same this time. So I made a little gap, and yeah. Then I kept going and said, no, this time it cannot happen again.
Yeah, I couldn't help but I looked across the road.
Yeah.
From 12th there, and I wondered if you were thinking that.
Yeah.
I remember in 2007, just being surprised when we crossed the pond, we thought you'd won.
Yeah.
To hear, why did Unger won?
Yeah, it was pretty much the same as this race, because I dropped Danny in the same point when I dropped Frodo, but it was not a big gap, so Danny came again and just screamed. I couldn't beat him. But this time I felt stronger, probably the whole last K was more consistent.